Hello everyone, welcome back. Thank you for tuning in and being here today. If you're new, welcome to my channel. I hope you find these tutorials helpful for you. Today we're going to learn how to paint fireworks. I'm excited about it because it's very colorful and I'm all about the colors. So let's see what happens and let's just go straight to the material list and go over what we need today. For brushes, we need a couple of these blending brushes. These artist lot brushes, this is a number 8. And this is a number 4. Any half an inch flat brush. And any detail brush. For paints, I like to use acrylics, and we need titanium white, cadmium medium yellow, naphthol medium red, ultramarine blue, and carbon black. We need a jar of water, a palette of some sort, whatever you're comfortable using, and a palette knife, some paper towels, and a blow dryer if you have this. This is a 16 by 20 inch canvas, and that's it for materials. And all the materials are in the description down below if you're interested. Before I start mixing my paint and my palette, I'm going to describe what we're going to do here. Most of this is going to be pretty dark and, you know, there'll be some hints of colors, but it's going to be a dark scene because it's a night scene. And then we will add maybe a few little boats here. The horizon line will be right in here, a little bit lower than half. And then maybe there's a boat here. Little city going on, city lights here on the reflecting on the water. The bottom will be all water here and some fireworks on top here. So let's see what happens and have fun. First things first, let's pick up our titanium white and our palette. And let's create, since again, it's gonna be mainly dark, I'm not gonna add too much white, but let's just create a few, let's just do 4 for now. And I'm using like a thumbnail, a small amount, okay? And I'm gonna just create 4 of these for now, like this, about the same size, okay? Now let's pick up our orange, or I mean yellow, and let's add just a little bit right here, and then a little bit here, and that's it, just on 2 of them for now. And now, red, let's add the red a little bit in here and a little bit in here and maybe some in here. Okay, next will be the blue, and we're going to use a lot of blue. So let's go ahead and add the blue. I'm going to add it right in here a little bit, a little more in here, and then another one right in here, like this. And I'm going to cover the whole canvas. So I'm going to try to make sure I have enough to cover the whole canvas, okay? But this is what I have, and I'm going to create one more shade actually, right in here. Let's just do this one will be our darkest. I'm going to add black in there. So let's pick up our black. Just a little bit like this. Okay. Right here, I'll show you a little bit of what I've got so far. All right. And now let's first mix our colors and then we'll see what we can add for to any of these, okay? So let's mix this one first real quick. And I just want it to be colorful, the sky, but not too bright. So I'm starting off with a little bit of paint and then I'll add more to it. So this is gonna be like a light orange, but I think I'm gonna add more red to this. Let's do that. Let's add a little bit more red, just because I don't want it to be too bright. Like this, okay? That's much better. Okay, next. Should be similar, but I'm gonna actually add more red to this because I want it to be darker. So it's gonna turn out to be the same, but I'm gonna add more red. You could see a lot more red right there. And let's blend it all in. It should be darker than this one. And, you know, if your colors, I always remind you guys and tell you this, that if your colors are a little bit lighter or darker, that's okay. Just see what, mix the colors that you want your sky to look. I'm just actually having fun and trying to see what colors I like in my sky. Yours could be a little bit different, you know, play around, see what you could come up with. But I want my sky to be colorful, but also a little bit dark. Because once we add our fireworks, we want the fireworks to stand out. Against the background, you know, sky. And we don't want the sky to be too bright, the background. Okay, next, this one. And I am going to add, definitely going to add more blue. And blue and red. So let's do that real quick. Right there. That's nice. Very nice. Next is just white and blue. We'll mix that real quick. And that's going to be very bright, as you could see. So I'm going to actually leave it. I'm going to leave this color the way it is. I like it. I like it bright like this. I'm gonna add some of that in the sky. And then here, I'm going to add a little bit of white also. You could see right there. I'll mix that real quick. Right there, and then our last color is going to be our darkest, and I think I'm going to make one more color after this, and then we'll be ready to blend the whole background in and add these colors and see what happens. There you go. You could see it's very dark, and I'm going to create one more color here. I decided to add another color, but I'll lean it. It's going to lean towards red more, so I'll show you what I mean by that. I also added a little bit of black right there, red, so maybe two thumbs and then a touch of black, and I'm going to maybe take part of this color just a little bit, just for fun, like this, and then just blend it all in. There you go, that's nice. Like a cherry color. Nice dark color. Okay. So we have the blues and we have the reds. the warm colors and the cold colors. We want that all over our sky. Okay, let's begin painting. So let's pick up our water and one of our blending brushes. I'm gonna dab it in all the way or halfway and just squeeze it out. You don't want it to be have a lot of water, but you want it to be nice and damp. So maybe leave some water in there so it can run smooth on the canvas. It helps from not, at doing that helps from the paint not to dry so quickly. And then our second blending brush we use to quickly blend everything in. It works really nice. So let's now start off with adding our lightest colors everywhere. So I'm gonna pick up my, let's go ahead and pick up this color right here. Okay, just take it all. And let's just add it, you know, let's add it like in a corner here. Bring it down like this. Maybe let it fade out like that. Take it all. There you go. And I'm dabbing tip in the water to make my brush damp again. And I'm gonna pick up some more. So I'm gonna go, my next color is this red. I'm just gonna put it right there. It's okay if it covers some of this. Put it on the bottom here. Okay, just take it all. There you go. I'm gonna dab my brush in the water again. Now I'm gonna use this blue because it's pretty light, and I'm gonna add it right in here. Just put it all in here, it's okay. Just cover everything. Dab my brush in the water and add some in here. Every time I pick up more paint, I dab my brush in the water. Some more in here. Okay, dab my brush in the water again. Pick up more of this color. Okay, dab my brush in the water. Let's pick up this color now. And let's just add it right in here. Let's just make our sky colorful. And randomly add it in here. Dab my brush in the water again. There you go, that's good enough. Now let's just pick up our red. Let's continue with this dark red and add it. Let's do it right in here. Let's just add everything in here with this red. Okay. Maybe add it a little bit in here. Like that. Okay, that's good. It's good enough. Now let's add this blue. Let's add the blue right in here. Just cover everything. Oops, there's a little mistake there, but that's okay. We'll fix that later. Don't worry about touching it and trying to fix it if that happened to you. Okay, now let's add that blue in here. And then dab my brush and use our final color and just cover everything in here. Maybe add some in here as well. Okay. This dark color. Just blend it in with the red, just all over like this. Okay. And I will cover the rest of this canvas right here. And work fast, you know, just put all the cover, or cover the canvas. Doesn't have to be perfect, because this is just our base. So, don't Don't spend too much time trying to make it perfect. Okay, there you go. And now I'm gonna put my palette down, pick up my second blending brush right here, and I'll blend everything in, working dry. And I'm gonna start from the lightest area. Blend, you see how that worked nicely? Even if there's a little bit, that's totally okay. But you could see I'm barely pressing the canvas, and I'm gonna just start with the lightest areas and work my way upwards. First, let's do the sky. Actually, let's quickly just, since this is the water, it doesn't have to be perfect, so just go back and forth like this, softly. Just back and forth. That's good with the water. Let's continue from here where we left off and work our way upwards. Barely pressing the canvas. There you go. Okay, while this dries, I'm gonna quickly clean out my brushes so they won't sit in the water too long. And I'm gonna use this amazing handmade soap with essential oils by one of our awesome patrons. If you're interested in these, they're in the description down below. Okay, I got my clean water, and the canvas is still a little bit wet, so I'm gonna quickly dry it out using this guy. Okay, now our background is dry, we can continue. And what I've got here is I added a little bit of black, a touch of yellow and red. And I'm gonna quickly mix those in. It'll be a very dark color. It's okay if you have a little bit of the blue, the dark blue mixed in with this color, it's totally fine. Maybe even take the leftover darks, mix it all in, it's totally fine. I just don't want to use the straight black, but you can if you want to. Okay, right there. And now let's pick up our flat brush right here, half an inch, dab it in the water. And let's just create a horizon line. And we'll start from right in here maybe. And just go straight like this. So I'm just gonna guess. There you go, dab my brush in the water. You can use masking tape, there's different ways to make your line straight, but I just like to wing it. As you could see. All right, we got our straight line like this, and now I'm gonna pick up my, let's pick up our number 8. Dab it in the water, also squeeze the water out so it could be nice and damp. And let's continue using this color. And let's just add it about this high. Just randomly. We're gonna add some lights in there. But just randomly add that. This will be where the city will be. I'm gonna continue adding maybe a few in here. I'm gonna draw the boat here, so it's gonna be, this area is gonna be covered, but we'll get to that. Let's first just add our details, maybe make this a little bit taller, like this. There you go. Okay, so I added just a teeny bit of white, yellow, some red and blue straight out of the tubes, and I'm gonna pick my detail brush, dab it in the water, and you know, so it could be nice and damp. And I'm gonna start with, let's just start with yellow, and let's put some yellow, pretend there's, you know, lights and things going on in the faraway distance with just the yellow. Okay, and then we'll continue on this side. Maybe draw some straight ones. Make a big couple lights in here in the city. You could see I'm randomly adding, yet I don't really have a plan. You could, you know, spend a little more time on this and add your details, but I'm just gonna quickly make this very simple. And dab my brush in the water. It's okay if I'm taking some of the black. Okay, that was the yellow. Now I'm cleaning my brush and I'm gonna use the red. And maybe actually mix it in with the yellow. Just play around, get an orange color. How about that, like this. Just some water and mix it in with your brush, swirl it, and then whatever orange you get, add some orange. Okay, clean my brush, and then I'm gonna add some blue. I'm gonna mix it in with the white, just the blue and white, and do the same thing, go over and maybe add some blues in my city. make it nice and colorful. Okay, that's good enough. And I'm going to just use the white. And quickly add in a few more details with just the white. Maybe make some straight lines. Okay, there you go. And I'm going to put my detail brush down and then pick up my flat half an inch brush, dab it in the water, and then I'm going to use some of this yellow. Maybe mix it in with the white a little bit, like this. And let's just add some on the bottom, right in here. Maybe some in here. Let's mix it in with the white a little bit so it can stand out. And then I'm going to follow some of these lights and then just follow it onto my water and fade it out. Some yellow. Dab it in the water. Reflection of the city. And then maybe a little bit of white, and then maybe one in here. That's good enough right there. that. Okay, and now I'm gonna just use the red. Like I said, it doesn't have to be, you know, perfect. Just the red and some yellow. Let's make it nice and orange. And I'm gonna add some in here. You can see I'm randomly adding them. There you go. That's good enough. And I'm gonna do that with the blue. Now my brush in the water. Maybe not everywhere. Just on some of the areas. Mix the blue in with the red. Let's do a darker one. And I will add it right in between these two. Okay, just red and blue. You can use your finger. There you go. Let's add some in here. Maybe some in here. I'm gonna dab my brush in the water and just draw some straight lines. Try to make them straight. Few more. And then here you can use the dark one. Remember this dark color we used as a background? as you get closer to the darker area, just some water in this color, and then let's add a few lines here with water. There you go, that's good. That is good. And let's draw our boat. And I'm going to use this dark color again. And sketch out the shape of my boat, okay? So I'm going to have him be... Let's have him be... right in here. And he's going to be quite long. It's going to be a big ship. Just fill it in. And then here, we'll come back to the details on the water, but let's clean our half an inch brush and use some of the white here. White, maybe with a yellow a little bit. And I'm going to add details to this boat. Okay. And there's a bunch of lights going on there. I'm going to use some yellow and add we're going to reflect that on the bottom. And then do the same thing what we did with these. I'm gonna add some red. And maybe a little bit of this darker color. Clean my brush. And I'm going to add white and yellow, whatever color it turns out. And right where the boat, right at the bottom, just draw out a straight line. And then with the darker one, add some lines fading out. And with a detail brush, use some white, maybe mix it in with the yellow, and water, and outline your boat very lightly. Add little details if you want to it. Okay, that's good. And do the same thing with a darker color and water. Okay, you can spend a lot of time detailing, you know, the city, the water, but let's continue and add the fun stuff, which is the fireworks. So I have my detail brush and I added more of the color, primary colors you could see. And I'm gonna dab my brush in the water and start off with just the white one right here with water. And let's just create a few fast, you know, lines. Maybe one goes here, maybe one goes up there. And one of our firework is gonna be up here. And I'm kind of just flaking it out, you know? We'll make this area very bright, so I'm going to add more of the white here. And add one in here. And maybe one next to it. We'll continue with this color and add more. I'm going to add one in here. one red in here. I think this will be the tallest. Maybe one in here. I'm going to switch to my flat brush and mix that with a little bit of blue. Okay, right there. And then I'm going to create a few bright ones here with the blue. Maybe another one right in here somewhere. Clean my brush out, add white, and I'm going to clean my brush out again and use white and yellow. clean my brush. Use white. White and red, and maybe a little bit of orange. Let's mix and make a green, light green. Whatever color you have made and you like it, use it. And then here I'm gonna use my number 8 brush and quickly blend those in just with a clean brush and water so it could create a nice glow effect. And yellow, just the yellow, and white and blue. I'm not taking too much paint. So I'm going to clean my brush. Okay, you got the quick sketch of your fireworks onto your canvas, and now you can detail them. And this is the part where it'll take a while. You can work at your pace, and I'm just gonna use white for now and create, you know, go over some of them. Maybe make some of them a little bit separate. clean out our brush, use a little bit of red and yellow. Now we're gonna use number 4, dab it in the water, and I wanna create a few colors using water, just red. And go over some of these. Clean my brush and use the blue. Do the same idea, same thing. Water and blue. Go over and add a nice blue over some of these. And yellow. And water. And maybe follow that down a little bit. Flat brush and some white and blue. the red in a flat brush. Go over some of these on the side. Okay, I could go on and on detailing the fireworks using these colors and just adding as much as I want. You could take a break, come back to it the next day. Totally up to you. You could add details on the bottom, on the water, on the city, on the boat. Have fun with this. See what you can create. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for being here and tuning in. If you have any questions, please let me know down below in the comments. And be sure to stay tuned for next week's tutorial. Take care and God bless.